Hello there, I am the MPD Gamer, and thank you for joining me once again. This is LEGO Star Wars, and we are about, I believe, to enter the second vehicle level of this. Yep, second vehicle level. I'm in the Millennium Falcon, trying my best to escape from Hoth. Now, in the movies, this bit always confused me. I'll admit, it's a little stupid for me to be confused by it, but perhaps I'm right in my lack of comprehension. But if, as they say, the Millennium Falcon doesn't have hyperdrive, because, you know, it's shite, the Falcon's quite well known for being temperamental as anything. But if they don't have hyperdrive, how are they able to get to the asteroid field? Because in the Hoth system, there is not an asteroid field. It's not depicted in the films at any point. So how did they manage to get to the asteroid field? And therefore, and from there to Bespin, they don't have a hyperdrive. They don't have light speed. So how can they get all the way across the galaxy and to the point at which they do with no hyperdrive? Perhaps I'm overthinking it, perhaps I'm just being a little bit douchey about it. I don't know, but it always bugged me a little bit. Especially now that I've actually developed the ability to think properly. And the inclination towards doing so as well. My apologies if I've just raised something which none of you have noticed or thought about yourselves. If I have, hopefully I've given you something to think about. If I've questioned your faith in Star Wars, I didn't mean to. But, you know, I like to poke holes in people's theories and plot holes and etc. I'm just a bit of a bastard sometimes. So, you know, sorry if I upset you in the process. Now the only thing I never liked about this bit, just here, is having to find more photon torpedoes somewhere in an asteroid. Because that's completely logical. Although what am I saying? I'm questioning the logic of a LEGO based game. I really need to think these things through before I actually say them, don't I? Ah well, such is life. It's a bitch. And then you end up marrying one. But, hell. If you're smart, you don't. However, intelligence has never exactly been my strong suit, especially when it comes to emotional relationships. Well, any kind of relationship, be it emotional or not. I'm not exactly the smartest of people. I'm half of it. However, I have managed to learn the best places to find the play these particular levels, and just for future reference, the best way to play these levels is, well, to be perfectly honest, an absolute buttload of cheats, and that bugs me so badly. It's because it shouldn't be. It's supposedly the fastest hunk of junk in the galaxy, and it's been nerfed essentially. Thank you. this bit is just a bit of a patience game. You've got to be patient and wait for the Vulcan torpedo targets to come by. And present you with a shot. Okay, there is a point where you can die even with the invisibility cheat off. Don't get too close to affect an asteroid. We should have figured that. We should have remembered it from last time we played this game. And there we go. That's all gone. But I've still got, I think, one last Star Destroyer to take out. Or maybe not. Apparently not. Floating away with the garbage. Because that's where the Millennium Falcon truly belongs. Now to head to Dagobah. This one used to take me a very long time to actually complete. Just because I never got the hang of Yoda and Luke at the same time. I don't know why. It shouldn't have taken me anywhere near as long as it did. And I shouldn't have done quite so badly, but, you know, I was a child, and I will be continuing to use that excuse the entire way through. Because it's a good excuse, and it works. At least, it makes me feel better about myself. No, R2! Hopefully you survive! And he's good. Yeah, I do find it quite amusing that right at the start there's several things that you can use that you need to use the force to get, but you can't use the force at all. But you learn how to essentially master the force by the end of the level. Or at least get a shite ton better at it. Because Luke's force abilities are pretty pitiful at the moment. Pretty much non-existent. Well, they are completely non-existent at this moment, at this point in time. But all he's been doing for training is he gave him a little bit of gobshite with a random attempts. A little bit of telekinetic practice, some lessons given to him by the ghost of Ben Kenobi. But nothing major. Hence, going to Dagobah. Because otherwise Luke's just going to he's going to suck. And unless he gets his acting gear, he's never going to be able to face Vader. Let alone the Emperor. But he's always got to have his trusty droid. Give him a hand. Whoops. And I can't remember if there's a way up. Nope, there isn't. Gotta go all the way back. And I'm at Yoda's. Hello, you wrinkled old mystic. Nice to see you again. I think Luke's just showing off there. I'm being a bit of a cunt. I'm sorry, I don't like using that word, but he's being quite a prick. Just there. That's appropriate. He really is going to get caught between a rock and a hard place. Working with Yoda. Feeling so many rocks around. And the hard place being his head. He's got quite a thick skull. I have to say though, finally having Luke with a lightsaber is quite satisfying. And of course, having the fast force ability on is even better. Because it doesn't really take much for me to actually do any of this. Without the fast force ability on, moving things around with the force takes absolute fecking ages. And it shouldn't be anywhere near as long. Just so frustrating sometimes. I think that may actually be the first time I've ever got 3 Jedi on this level without having to go back for a free play. Although, if I'm perfectly honest, I do have the times 2 score booster on. So it's not necessarily a surprise. I can actually get this time right. There's another little bit which drove me up the wall when I first started playing this, when I first did this level. I couldn't get the timing right to save my life. I kept having to swap back out, find Yoda, get him back on my back, so I could actually do any of the force stuff. Because just watching. I'm trying to activate the force with Luke, without Yoda on my back, and I can't do shite. I mean, I know that Yoda's training Luke so to actually do stuff, but now I can in theory use the force without having to rely on Yoda, but even so, it's still irritating. Come on, R2, where are you? There you go. I don't think anyone actually realizes just how useful R2 is. He's in every single film, and he does so very much. He's practically an ex machina character. He's just there to help the story progress. And that's what he does. He does it brilliantly. He saves the Naboo cruiser. He helps Dark Anakin Skywalker take out the droid control ship. He sticks with Anakin the whole way through the Clone Wars and somehow manages to get to join R2. Somehow manages to get to join Luke. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that's definitely an ex machina type character. And I don't think R2 gets the recognition he deserves. At all. Fake Darth. What little you realize, I'm so powerful in the Force that I'm invincible. Nothing you can do can hurt me. No matter how much you try, you cannot stop me. I have to say though, I do really like the lesson that Luke is forced to learn by Yoda in the cave. And Yoda tells him that he doesn't need his weapons, so Anakin automatically takes his weapons because he's too used to danger. And so his automatic response to anything is to fight it with violence. Which, as anyone who knows anything about Star Wars knows, that is not the Jedi way. But I digress. Well, bye-bye, Darth. I will be seeing you again later. But not yet. Not yet. Not yet. On the bridge. I think I'm nearly done this one as well. If I'm right, and I suspect that I am, I'm very nearly done. Alright, I am quite nearly done then. Come on, Yoda. Up you come. Force powers in concert. Something you don't get to see after the prequel trilogy until this point. It's so satisfying. However, having to stop building for the sake of taking care of a bat isn't. It's quite irritating, that. And happens on far more occasions than I'd like. Up until you get the fast build perk, which, to be perfectly honest, is pretty feckin' awesome. And now, use the Force, and fail. Because Luke hasn't unlearned what he has learned, and then Yoda comes around, and badasses it up. What is that little pose for there? Like, what the fuck? You broke my ship! Frick. And off he goes. Into a trap. Well, thank you for watching. It's been an absolute pleasure, once again. I've been the MPD Gamer. Please leave me a like, drop me a comment, or even subscribe. It's what I do this for.